my still. It's called Dante. Yes, Dante's Inferno, but it's also a good name in general. This is the boiler, made of stainless steel barrels, 55-gallon drum. Well, one of them. Everything is stainless. It's electrically heated. It's really just a barrel. It's been polished up. Has a few little brackets welded onto it. We don't want to lose any essential oil through vapor before it can be condensed. So this just makes a seal between the basket and the boiler. This is our plant material basket. One of the two. Just putting pine needles in. This has been mulched through a shredder. Pinus strobus. There's a balance you have to achieve of how much to pack the material. I usually just kind of even it out to start and then give it a few packs. If you don't pack it, the steam will make little pockets and pass through without actually passing through the material. It'll make tunnels. So this is shredded material that is about an inch, that wood that's about an inch in diameter, and the needles. And I shred the material because you can fit a whole lot more in here. It also makes the oils more accessible to the steam than if you had whole wood with bark on it. Put it in there carefully so it doesn't mess up the gasket. Get it out of alignment. Make sure there's no particles here for this sealing of the next gasket. So a $2 tube of silicone made a gasket that a custom gasket maker would have charged hundreds of dollars for, because they would have had to make a custom mold. Okay, now I'm gonna fill this charge basket, plant material basket, much heavier. So I'm gonna partially fill it and put it on a still and then fill it the rest of the way. For about 100 pounds of white pine, I am expecting about 400 milliliters of oil. So the total volume of the two baskets is about 35 to 40 gallons. And that translates to roughly about 110 pounds of conifer material like this, or up to about 120 pounds of the ginger pulp. Good. So these are not to necessarily keep it. They're to keep the steam from escaping right here, but mainly just to keep everything from wanting to lift from the pressure underneath. Now there's not a lot of pressure underneath because it's a big open pathway for the vapor to get out, which is what you want with essential oil distilling. You don't want pressure. Okay, now the final gasket and the lid, and we're ready to wait. So this part is important to line up as evenly as possible, because I learned that my lid sealing surface right at the edge of the gasket if it's perfectly round. So try to make it as even as possible around the edges. And I have an arrow again, just so that it always goes on the same way. So now I'm going to put the condenser on. It's got this PTFE gasket, dry clamp fitting. This is the condenser, homemade. If you look down in here, I don't know if you can see it, but there's three tubes in there. Those three tubes run through the whole length and come out this end. I know that's not the most beautiful welding, but whatever. It works. That's the point. And then water, cooling water, comes in down here, gets pushed up, and comes out here. So this is a jacket. The water goes through the jacket and cools the three tubes, allowing the vapor to condense into water, liquid. In this case, the distillate is called hydrosol and essential oil. And in a little bit, you'll see how the oil gets separated from the hydrosol. Okay. The unique design of the essencier allows the hydrosol to come out the bottom into this container and the oil to come out the top into our other container. Okay, so we're going to wrap up this distillation now. It's been about 6.5 hours since we started. The oil has been dripping for about 4 hours now. So real quick overview of what we're going to do. We're going to close this up and force this oil to come out into our collection vessel. And then to clean out the condenser, I'm actually going to move all this aside, shut off the cooling water, and let the steam clean it out. Just push it all out. So let's go. I'm just blocking the hydrosol so that it forces this level to raise, forcing the oil out the top. The other option would be to raise this adjustable side up, but there's no need to do that. I have to be quick and responsive with this. You know, when I send water out with the oil, I'm going to stop it right about now. And then I'll lower this down. saw how that just brought down the whole level of everything. Okay, I might lose a drop here, but it'll be okay. So here's the oil we collected. There are a couple little water drops in there. You can probably see them moving around at the bottom. Looks like we've come to about 200 milliliters. So now I'm gonna shut off the cooling water again to push all the oil that's stuck inside here out into here. And it's okay to not have anything under here because this is adjusted down. The water level and oil level is not gonna come above that. So we just stopped the cooling water, and over the next minute or two, the condenser is going to start heating up, and then it'll turn to steam and start cleaning it out. You can see actually there's putting out a ton of oil right now. This is all oil that's stuck inside the condenser. I'm going to call that done. These are 10 milliliter bottles, and this is a 10 milliliter pipette. And it's just a matter of filling this guy up. I only use one pipette per species. In other words, I won't use this pipette for ginger after the Fraser fir. You have to overfill it a little bit because when you pull it out of the oil, it goes down. So as you can see, bottling our oils is very much a hands-on process. No mass bottling here. These are safety caps that come with the bottles. So once you screw them on, they click and it's sealed. It's got that safety ring that when you open it for the first time, it'll, you know, break that ring. So I generally do one oil at a time so I don't get mixed up and mislabel an oil. Or one species of oil, that is. At this point, I'm not incredibly concerned about how straight the labels are. I try to get them straight, but if it's slightly off, that just adds a little character, lets you know it's handmade.